This tutorial will show you how to set up real-time sync for continuous folder synchronization. The basic function of real-time sync is to monitor a folder, wait for file change notifications, and then execute a user-defined command line. Most of the time, however, real-time sync will be used to run a FreeFileSync batch job. So let's start real-time sync. In order to get a default configuration quickly, just load an already existing FreeFileSync batch job. Here, we have a simple mirror synchronization that will copy our work files to a backup drive. As you see, real-time sync has already copied the list of folders from the batch job, all of which will be watched for changes. Idle time lets you configure a time span after real-time sync has detected a change in which no further file changes should occur. If an additional file change notification is received, the timer is reset and real-time sync starts waiting again until the full number of seconds have passed without any new file changes. The idea behind this strategy is to run the command line at a time where it is unlikely that other applications are still writing to the monitored directories. For idle time, let's set 5 seconds. The command line is already set up to start FreeFileSync and run the batch job. Begin directory monitoring by pressing Start. Real-time sync is now running minimized in the notification area. Let's test if the mirror job is really triggered when we change a file. Therefore, I'm opening the source and target folders of the mirror batch job. Let's delete a file and create a new one. And indeed, the change was detected by real-time sync, and our FreeFileSync batch job has copied over the changes after 5 seconds of idle time. Now that we have real-time sync running correctly, let's activate it automatically whenever we log in. First, we save the changes made to real-time sync in a configuration file. One way to start real-time sync is by just double-clicking this file, but in order to have the operating system do this for us during login, we place this file into the startup folder. To locate the folder, enter shell:startup into the Explorer address bar. Now restart your system. And here is real-time sync running in the notification area. You can stop real-time sync at any time via the context menu that is shown when you right-click on the icon.